I'll try to give a brief overview of how I managed to use an old exercise bike as a gamepad. Note that your exercise bike might be completely different from mine, and the procedure might be a bit different, but this video should give you a rough idea on how it's done. Here's a close look of the exercise bike. I've used an ESP32 microcontroller as it comes with Bluetooth, and I wanted to turn my bike into a wireless gamepad. It is powered using a power bank, and there's an OLED display to show the distance pedaled as the built-in display isn't working. Here's the exercise bike from far. The first thing I wanted to do was to figure out how fast I was pedaling. So I took apart the bike's display and found that there were two wires connecting the base of the bike to the bike's display circuit. The wires are probably connected to a magnetic switch. I connected these two wires parallelly to the ESP32, assuming one was ground and the other having some type of signal. I then wrote a program in Arduino IDE to monitor the signal pin and got a square wave when pedaling. The faster I pedaled, the more pulses I got. Note that I had to pull the input high to get a square wave. Thus, we can figure out how fast we pedal based on the number of pulses obtained in a second. The distance can be computed by counting the total pulses. Most exercise bikes give an approximate distance value, as distance traveled on a bike is based on the bike's wheel diameter, and we do not have a wheel. Now we need some buttons to interact with the game. My exercise bike came with these metal touchpads. They were originally used for the heart rate sensor, but as the built-in display wasn't working, it isn't possible to see the heart rate. So I decided to use them as gamepad buttons. The ESP32 comes with capacitive touch sensitive GPIO pins. Thus, we could just hook up the metal touchpads to the specified GPIO pins and monitor if the touchpad is being touched or not. But unfortunately, when I used long wires connecting the touchpads to the GPIOs, I managed to get accidental presses, probably due to parasitic capacitance. Touching one pad would result in two GPIO pins going high. Although sometimes this did work fine, I couldn't get it to work all the time, and there were far too many accidental button presses. So I decided to use these touch modules. Although this made the wiring more complex, it worked well. Note that I had to use a ceramic capacitor to adjust the touch sensitivity. Now we need the ESP32 to be recognized as a Bluetooth gamepad, with the pedal and touchpads as inputs. There's an ESP32 BLE gamepad library on GitHub by the user LemmingDev, which lets us easily do this. I had some issues with the Bluetooth not pairing properly. To solve this, I would suggest you to keep your code as similar to the example code as possible. In most racing games, the gamepad right trigger acts as the accelerator pedal. Thus, we could use the pedal pulse count as an argument for the set right trigger function. In reality, the code isn't this simple. You would have to map the pedal count range to the right trigger range. This is done by experimenting with different values. A gamepad button can be pressed if the touchpad is pressed. For the complete program, do have a look at my blog post in the description. After pairing the ESP32 with the computer, the ESP32 is recognized as a generic gamepad. But most PC games need the gamepad to be recognized as an Xbox 360 controller. So we need to use the X360 controller emulator. I've configured this for the game Rocket League. Since we have only 4 touchpads, I mapped the 4 touchpads to the most essential Xbox 360 buttons to play the game, which were to steer left, right, jump, and rocket boost. The right trigger is selected as Axis Y, which has the output of the set right trigger function. The X360 emulator lets us combine 2 controllers. Thus, we can combine a regular gamepad with our exercise bike to have more buttons. Not all Android games do support gamepads, but for the ones that do, the buttons can be configured according to this image. So button 1 in the program becomes button A of the controller. Depending on the game, the buttons can be selected appropriately. If you'd like to see a more detailed tutorial along with the programs, do check out my blog post in the description.